Hey guys, how are you guys doing tonight? You guys good?
Good.
Yeah.
Yeah. I got a question for you guys I forgot to ask earlier. And some of you guys may know this question, and if you know the question, you know the answer, so please, give me the answer. Alright, that question, if you don't know, just listen, and then you're gonna know the answer. Alright, so if you're new to this question, then you know what to do, right? You guys already know, right? You guys already know. Don't think you can say it. No? Alright, my question is, you down with OMG? You know, we're winding down with the event for tonight. I do have a spoken word for you guys. This is called He is Greater. I wrote this today, so it's a work in progress. So bear with me if I kind of mess up. Just go ahead and laugh. All right, let's see here. This is called He is Greater. Let me read you a little something that I wrote. Please lend me your ears, I'm gonna try and keep this short. He is greater than I. Not only is he greater than I, but he is greater than my troubles. Day to day troubles comes my way. Christ himself promised that in this world there will be trouble, but nevertheless to take heart, because he has overcome this world. Whether it's a dead car battery, a relationship torn, sickness in our body, feeling pain, feeling tired, feeling worn, losing a job, losing a loved one, or even losing my phone. You see, trouble comes in sizes great or small, yet he is greater than them all. He is greater than my troubles. He is greater than I. Not only that, but he is greater than my temptations. And believe me, temptations do come. Lies, lust, stealing, gluttony, hate, envy, laziness, idolatry, you name it. I am far from perfect. The enemy knows this. He knows what my weakness is. And when he attacks, he is relentless. And though I may struggle to overcome, you know, I strive to emulate the one and only Son. Jesus Christ was tempted just like you and me. And each time he was tempted, he took home the victory, which demonstrates that it can be done. He didn't just overcome some. He overcame all. Not once did he slip. Not once did he trip. Not once did he fall. Not once did he give in to sin. But each temptation he was given, he would win. He is greater than my temptations. He is greater than I. He is greater than me. You see, I am not the man I used to be. I was and still am a sinner. That's present tense. And while day by day I sin less and less, there are still parts of my life that is a total mess. A mess that only Christ could cleanse. Like greasy smudges wiped away on a camera lens, I am nothing without God. But with him, I am one of his, adopted into his family, joining in the family biz, taking on the ministry to share the good news and to teach biblical truths. And though I rejoice that I am saved, that I am forgiven, that I am redeemed, I'm reminded that my soul would be lost if it wasn't for him. My salvation would not be possible if the perfect Lamb of God did not die when he took his last breath, and on the third day rose again, defeating death. That is the reason. That is why I am forever reminded that he is greater than I. Praise God, guys. Yeah.